Now explaining ray diagrams of concave mirror. How to draw ray diagram in concave mirror. So there are six ray diagrams we have to study in class 10. But I am explaining only two diagrams because diagram 1 and 2, 3, 4, 5 all are almost same. Only the rules which I have explained in the previous video is used to draw the diagram. Only in the last one, this is the number second, that is the last one, sixth diagram. In this, we have some change. So I will explain this one and the rule number one and the diagram number one. Okay. Let's start diagram number one. How to draw a ray diagram in a concave mirror. So at least out of four rules, at least we have to use two rules. What means, yeah, we have to take two rays at least to draw a ray diagram. At least two rays to form an image. So first I am taking when the object is placed at infinity. It's like example is sun. Sun is very far from us. Thus, for us, that is the object is placed at infinity. Means sun is placed at infinity. Whenever an object is placed at infinity, the ray of light always come parallel to each other and parallel to principal axis. It is not every time sure that the lines will be, the rays will be parallel to principal axis. But it will be sure that the line will be parallel to each other. This is sure, but this is not sure that it will always be parallel with principal axis also. That I'll explain in the next video. See what happens when the lines are not parallel to principal axis. But at this time I am taking the rays of light which are parallel. Two rays I have taken. Both the rays are parallel to each other and also parallel to principal axis. According to the rule, two rays I have taken. One, two. According to the rules of ray diagram, when light strikes to the mirror, parallel light, it will return back because this is concave mirror and it is a converging mirror. The light, ray of light, after reflection will converge towards focus. And rule ray number 2 also strike the mirror with a different point and it will again, according to rule, it will reflect back on focus. This is called incident ray. These two are reflected ray. The point where both the reflected rays meet, that is the point of formation of image. After the completion of image, we have to write three things, P, S, N, where P is position of the image. Position of the image is at focus. Image is formed at focus. See, this place image is formed. Size, S for size. Size is very diminished, highly diminished. Diminished means very, very, very small, like point size. And nature of the image is because in this diagram, the rays only directly meets at a point. They are not appearing to meet. This is original incident ray, reflected ray. There is no dotted line. The rays itself meet. Thus, it is real and inverted image. This image is real, already explained in the class. Real image is the image which can be obtained on screen. This property of concave mirror is also used in automobiles headlights, where we keep bulb at focus and the light will go directly on the road. See, this is bulb, light is going on the road. This is concave mirror is used inside the headlights of the bulb. And anyone who want to know where will be the angle of incidence and reflection, you draw a dotted line from center of curvature and you will able to know where is angle I and R. Where is angle I and R. C is the normal incidence. Remember, is center of curvature is any line which is drawn from center of curvature will be the normal incidence. And it is basically normal.